equal x raised power n 1 plus n del x by x plus n into n minus 1 2 factorial del x by x whole square plus another factors, another properties, continuity of a binomial theorem minus 1. Now this one, 1 cancels, dividing both sides by delta y. Delta x, dividing both sides by delta x, we have del y by del x. Del y by del x is equal to x raised power n. Here becomes this. N by x. Del x neglecting divided by del x. Plus n into n minus 1 by 2 factorial. Del x by x. Del x by x square. Del x by x square. Plus so on. And taking now another step is taking limit this delta x tends to 0, delta x tends to 0 on both sides, we will get limit like this, limit delta x tends to 0 d del y by del x will be equal to limit delta x tends to 0. This taking limit delta x tends to 0 on both sides. Limit delta x tends to 0. X raised power n. And this equation n by x plus n into n minus 1 by 2 factorial del x by x square. And so on. Now as del x tends to 0. This dy by del y by del x limit and del x tends to 0, del y by del x, we represent this as dy by dx, which is the derivative of the limit delta x tends to 0, delta y by delta x. This is represented by dy by dx, known as the differential coefficient of a function. Differential coefficient of function with respect to x, dy by dx is equal to, take here, delta x tends to 0. Here only remains x raised power n into n by x. Rest of the terms, they are containing delta x. Delta x tends to 0, these whole terms will become 0 or they will vanish. Now we will get obvious result, that is dy by dx derivative of a function y with respect to x is equal to x raised power n into n by x, that becomes n times x raised power n minus 1. Here it is x raised power 1, it will become on numerator, this becomes x raised power minus 1, n times x raised power n minus 1. Hence the differential coefficient of x raised power n, differential coefficient d by dx of x raised power n, what is its value? Result, its value is n times x raised power n minus 1. So we have, by this method we have calculated the differential coefficient of x raised power n by Ebnishow method. In this Ebnishow method we have to take in 4 steps. First, I will recall here, first let us make it is a function y is equal to x first. Second, let there be small increment in x so that y plus del y is equal to x plus delta x. Third step is we have to subtract equation first from equation second, then y value eliminates, take the value divide by delta x, third step. Fourth one is taking limit delta x tends to 0, this limit dy by dx del x tends to 0, this will give us the derivative of function y with respect to x, or differential coefficient of y with respect to x. Now it is application. application of differential quotient or derivative of a function. By knowing the differential quotient that we have just derived, that is derivative d by dx of x raised power n, which is equal to n x raised power n minus 1, we can calculate physical quantities. For example, there is a, I have a problem. For example, I have mass of a, we know the mass of a body which is in motion with a certain velocity and have a taken some certain time. For example, I will write a problem, that is mass of a body, mass of a body is 2.5 kilograms which is in motion with a certain velocity v after time t. That is velocity we have given, are given, velocity v is equal to t cube by 3 plus t square by 2 plus 1. Now we have calculate the force acting on the body. Calculate the force acting on the body of mass 2.5 kgs with a certain velocity which is given at the time. And our time is t after the time 3 seconds. We have to find out the force. That is, we know that by calculating the force, we have to take consideration in our previous classes that force is equal to mass into acceleration. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. Taking this point into consideration, force, we have to calculate force, mass is given, we have to find acceleration. We know that acceleration of a body is the rate of change of velocity with respect to time. Acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with respect to time. We call as this derivative of velocity, differential coefficient of velocity with a given time. That is, which is, give the here the value, d by dt. Value of v is given, that is t cube by 3 plus t square by 2 plus 1. Or we will bifurcate this, that is d by dt of t cube by 3 plus d by dt derivative of t square by 2 plus d by dt of 1. Here 1 is constant. Derivative of a constant is 0. That is d by dt of a constant term, it is 0. Its value is 0. The relation d by derivative of t cube by 3, d by dt of t square by 2, d by dt of 1. As we have derived just the differential coefficient of x raised power n, which is n times x raised power n minus 1. Now here becomes d by dt of t cube. This will be equal to 3 times t cube by t square by 2, t square by 3, plus 2 times t minus 1, that is t by 2, plus d by dt of constant. D by dt of constant is 0. 3 big cancels, 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3, 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2. Here I will get t square by t. T square by t is our value. Now we are given. We are given in the question after time of 3 seconds. Our time is 3 seconds, then we will get, then this acceleration a will be equal to 3 square plus 3. When time is 3 seconds, this our acceleration t square by t, a is equal to t square by 3. That will be equal to 12 meters. Unit of acceleration is meter per second square. 12 meters per second square. Hence, we were asked to calculate the force. As we know, what is force? Force is mass into acceleration. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. We are asked in the question to calculate the force, which is mass into acceleration. Mass is our given. Now, force is equal to mass is 2.5 kgs, kilograms, into. We have calculated by different derivative method, acceleration, which is 12 meters per second square. Thus, our force is 30.0, that is 30, as the unit of force is Newton. Force is, we are able to calculate by applying mathematical tools when we are given mass and we were given velocity by calculating, applying derivative of a function, velocity dv by dt, which is acceleration, gives acceleration. By calculating acceleration, we are now able to find out the force of the body which is in motion. This force is 30 newton.